Hey guys, Welsknight here, and welcome back to another episode of Expedition. We're picking up shortly after where we left off last time. I cleared back this hill just a little bit. The grass hasn't spread yet, but it will. And in today's episode, what I want to do is I want to do a little bit of caving, get some basic materials going, some iron and all that kind of stuff, and I really would like to get our food situation settled. Hello, cave that goes down very deep. Let's be friends. I found this cave earlier, last episode, when we came to the village, and I wanted to kind of give this a look and see if maybe there's something that's... Oh! Almost just wasted my diamond Zane. That would have been... I probably would have cried just a little bit if that had gone into the lava and been destroyed. So, okay. So that's not a very useful cave. We do have a little bit of coal here, so I'll get that. I'm going to gather this up and I'm going to head to the other cave I found, which I think is a little bit more in the village itself. And I'll be back with you in just a sec. All right, guys, I am back, and what I'm doing right now is I wanted to bring you a little bit of a status update. I am looting all the food from the village that I can find, because I was going to go on a caving expedition, and then I realized I had, like, 3 pork chops left, and that is not going to be enough. That is not going to be nearly enough to go on a proper caving expedition, so I'm going to get all this wheat, and I'm going to see if maybe, just maybe... will be good to go now that I actually have some wheat that I can make into bread. I suppose I could actually cook it into toast as well. That might be the better thing to do. If I could get one bone... I wonder... Sometimes these drop bones. Like that. Look at that. There we go. We got bones. Okay. Cool. So we did a little grave robbing, stole a couple bones from the cemetery. Sorry. But that should give us everything we need now to get started with AgriCraft, because I believe I have 4 ingots. In fact, I'm almost positive that I've got 4 ingots sitting in the... in the house. So I'm gonna grab this wheat, and I think I'm gonna probably steal this too. But for now, holy cow, 274 right off the bat, 263, 515. I will take those two for sure, and we're gonna borrow this seed animal. Well, I'm not gonna borrow it. I have no intention of returning it. But I'm gonna take that with me too. That will definitely speed up our process. Considerably. We're going to be rolling in wheat before you know it, guys. All right, let me head home, and I'll be back with you in just a second. All right, guys, one thing we can do to give ourselves a little bit more food here is I can turn this bread into toast by cooking it. So what I'm going to do is I am going to make some mini coal from Z-tones, which will basically only cook one thing, and one coal makes 8 mini coals, so rather than having to basically ration out your coal in units of 8, shall we say, you can just make it mini coal and then not have to worry about it. And as you can see, the toast gives us a lot more bread, or a lot more hunger restoration? Hunger regeneration? Whatever. It gives us more hunger ticks than standard toast does. So we'll let that cook up. And then we should be able to get going with some of the other stuff. Now, the other thing I'm going to need in order to get started with AgriCraft is I'm actually going to need some sand as well. Although I don't technically need it, but it will be a lot easier on me if I get the sand. And I'll show you why in just a second here. I have customized a lot of the recipes within this mod pack. So... especially when it comes to AgriCraft and magical crops. And one thing that is very important, here we go, let's grab a little dirt, is making sure that whatever crops you're trying to grow, you've got the right kind of soil for it. Now, This soil is from Z-Tones, and it's basically just like regular farmland, except it can't be broken and or trampled or whatever you want to call it. And it will grow regardless of what light level it is and regardless of whether or not it's hydrated. So that's kind of a useful little thing. Let's just put a little garden right here. We'll just make a little 4x4. Won't be anything fancy. I'll peel that back a little bit. That should do the trick. And we'll just plant this stuff right here. Okay, so now the next thing we're gonna need is we've got 4 of those. I'm going to need, let's see, some slabs so we can make bowls. And then where'd those bones go? There we go. So now we have everything to make a watering can from extra utilities. And that will come in very handy as we are watering our crops and growing them, because it basically speeds up the rate at which that stuff grows. So let's grab these oak wood planks. I'm actually going to convert all of those, and let's make a bunch of crop sticks. Now we get a little bit of a head start here because we got lucky and found 2 seeds that are actually pretty good seeds. So let's go ahead and just breed those real quick. All right, guys, I have given up on just trying to crossbreed them. So I'm just going to breed them the old-fashioned way. Basically, what we're doing is we're just going to grow these like so. And then we'll put down a new row and let them spread. And every time they spread, they'll have a chance to increase in stats a little bit. And if you do this enough times, you'll end up with 10, 10, 10s no matter what. So, we're just going to get these going. We started with a 3, 7, 6. I'm going to let these spread until they get to this corner over here, and then I'll come back to you. All right, guys, we got another batch done. Let's take a look and check this out. And we have 10, 10, 10 wheat seeds. Awesome. Let's take a look and see if some of these other ones are also 10, 10, 10s. Looks like one of them might be. Let's see here. That's a 10, 9, or a 9, 10, 10, and that's, okay. So these are the only 10, 10, 10 wheat seeds. The rest of them are basically just junk seeds at this point. And we can just throw them into the compost bin and turn them into compost. But this will give us plenty of wheat and plenty of food, because we'll just turn it right into toast like that. There we go. And then I'll want to start cooking that up in a little while. In fact, yeah, let's go ahead and cook it up now. Why not? So we'll just go 20 like so, and I'll make some more mini coal and put that in there so it can all cook. And there we go. All right, so I'm going to let that cook up, guys, and then I'm going to go caving for a little bit. I'll be back with you once I'm in the cave. All right, guys, I am back. I've got the toast. I've got torches. I've got everything I need. I also made some ladders so that I can go down this hole and actually get back up, because that's always a good thing when you can get back up to where you initially started. So what I'm looking for in this caving expedition is I want to get some iron, I want to get some copper and tin, and I would really like to find some redstone and gold. That might be wishful thinking, but we'll see. And we can't mine this orichalcum either. That's too bad. I was hoping that the Diamond Zane would be able to do that. This is going to be a drop, isn't it? Yes, it is. That's okay. All right, so let's get this. Do I want to... Yeah, let's get our ladders up right away. We're just gonna make a little pathway here. There we go. Yeah, this looks like this cave goes relatively deep. That's good, that's good, that's really good. Okay, so let's see here, ladders. Let's just bring those up. I've got a pretty awesome plan for how we're going to power all of our machines. I'm basically going to run my entire base on toast. We're going to have a toast-powered base, at least to start with. Tell me that this is not the end of the cave, because if it is, that's like the most anticlimactic cave in the history of caves. Looks like it still goes on a little bit farther. That's a creeper. Stay away. Stay back. Go away. Leave me alone. And we can... I see a chupacabra sitting in there. And we've got more silver. I have a feeling I'm probably going to need that. I know I'll need the leadstone or the lead because I'm going to have to make fluid conduits. Ooh, resonating ore. Okay, so the big power generation mod in this mod pack, hello Lapis, is called Deep Resonance. That's a long way down. I don't like looking down and seeing lava. That scares me a little bit. And we... It would... Oh, diamonds! Any more diamonds? No, no more diamonds. Okay. Anyway, so the big power generation mod here is called Deep Resonance, and it's kind of late game stuff, but it also has some kind of earlier game stuff. We're probably not going to get to it too much in the early game, but that ore, that resonating ore that we just found, that's from Deep Resonance, and that's what we're ultimately going to use to build super powerful power generation later on in the series. Did I get all the redstone that's down here? I think I did. I want to get out of here before we run into one of those nasty ifrit things that shoots fireballs at you and kills you. Because those are never fun. Okay. So there we go. How much redstone we get? Oh, we only got 9 redstone. That's not going to be enough. I'm going to need a little more than that. Okay. Tell you what, guys. I'm going to do a little bit more caving. I'm going to do a little bit more looking around and resource gathering. And I'll be back with you in just a little bit. All right, guys, I am back. Check this out. We have found ourselves an abandoned mine shaft down here. That's pretty good. That's pretty awesome. I will definitely be very happy about that. And I found a bunch more redstone, which is great, because that's one thing that we really needed more of. For all the technical machines, they're all going to require redstone. And I just did not have enough. Can I reach that from here? Oh, I'm on fire. I'm on fire. Water? Water? Anywhere? Water? There's water over here. Okay, not on fire anymore. All right, guys, I am back, and I am really not having any luck finding more tin, or at least finding another cave, so I'm kind of over here. Oh, there's another village over there. We'll check that out in a minute. Our house is like right here, and we're kind of up here right now, because you can find tin just kind of sticking out in the stone in this biome, and that's kind of what I'm looking for right now, but I'm also gathering copper too, because 14 copper really isn't going to be enough. I'm going to want a lot more than that overall. 14 would be enough to get us started, but certainly not enough for us to do everything we want to do. Let's not fall in the quicksand. That would be really bad. Tin. There we go. Couple of dense tin deposits. Now we're talking 10. That's much... Oh, I made the Crimson Knights mad, and I have no armor. Oh, this is not going to be good. Nope. They are definitely still mad. Eat food faster, run away, just run for your life. There's no way I can take one of those guys right now. Where's he at? Did he leave? I think he left. I think we're okay. Whew, that was close. Those things would be very, very bad for me right now. But we're in a village, and we found a blacksmith, which means more loot, an elementium ingot, a weapon loot kit. Oh, man, there's all sorts of good stuff in here. There is all sorts of good stuff. All right, let's get rid of some junk. Let's see, the coal we'll take. The charcoal I don't really need. Yeah, that was a pretty good chest. Okay. So not too bad there. Is this... Oh. Oh, that's rather morbid. Okay. That's fine. That's fine. We'll just continue on our way. Let's see what's in the railcraft chest. A couple of weapon loot cases, common treasure, and some gears that I don't really need. I've already got a rolling machine from the last village, so I'm not too worried about that. Is that another blacksmith? I think that's another blacksmith. That is totally another blacksmith. Oh, man. This is our lucky day. What do we got in here? Bedrockium. Nice. Man, we're finding all sorts of good stuff. Okay, Terra Steel, yes. String, I don't need. The Bedrockium, I definitely want in here. Let's put some of these away. Copper, I will want. I think I really honestly want the lava bucket. Just for the bucket, if nothing else. And then the rest of this, I'll just kind of gather up. All right, I think we're off to a pretty good start. I still need to find a tiny bit more tin, but we are doing pretty well overall. Let's see, there's a little bit more. I don't need a lot more tin, just a little. If I get like 12 tin ingots, I think that's enough. And I've got 16, awesome. All right, guys, I'm gonna head back home and I'll meet you there. All right, guys, I am back and I am home and I think I need to make another chest. The disorganization in these chests is ridiculous right now, but I'll get organized later. That's not my primary concern. I think it's nap time. What I really need to do is I want to get these machines up and rolling. That was my goal for this episode, and I know this has probably been a longer episode, but that's okay. We're going to make it happen. So the first thing I'm going to want to make is a pulverizer. Here we go. And that's going to be a couple of copper gears, a redstone reception coil, some redstone, and a piston. I'm going to need a couple pistons, actually, for this whole project. So let's grab some wood. Let's grab some redstone. I'm going to need iron, and I'm just going to smelt up, I think, how much iron do I actually need for this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so I need 8 iron to make the pulverizer, and that will then allow me to ore double. So let's get those going. I'm going to need some sand. There we go. So let's get some of that going as well. You know what? Let's do this. You go in there, you go in there. And I'll put that in there too. Okay. And actually, let's make another batch of glass, like so. And then I'm going to need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 copper ore. And where's my tin? Where is my tin? As I said, disorganization. It's a horrible thing. There we go. And we got 4 tin as well. Okay. So we'll get that smelting up. I'll get all the resources together. In fact, you know what, guys? I'm just going to go ahead and get all the resources together for that and for a few other machines too. First, I suppose I should probably build our power source, though, since that I'm going to need for the pulverizer anyway. So the first thing I need to do is make a survivalist generator. And to make one of those, I need some cobblestone. There we go. Let's make a couple of pistons. Let's make like 3. That should be enough. And then I'll make a survivalist generator. I'm going to actually make 2 of those, like right off the bat, like so. And then I need more iron. Yep. Should have thought about that before. Let's see. How much iron am I going to need? I'm going to need 5, 10, and then, well, I really only need the 5, plus 1, 2, plus 6, 5 plus 7, 12. Perfect. Okay, there we go. So we'll get that going. We got this going here. We'll put our tin in there, and we are well on our way. Let me let this smelt for a little while, guys. I'll be right back. All right, guys, I am back, and I think I've got pretty much everything ready to go. So we are going to want another furnace. In fact, I'm going to want two more furnaces. And then we're going to make ourselves this, a culinary generator. And that is going to be our primary power source right now. And I will upgrade it more later. But for now, this will work. So we're going to put that in the corner right here. And this is essentially going to generate power on food. And we're going to generate it using toast in this case. So we're good there. Now, the next thing I need to do is make these gears. There's two, and like so. Then I need to make myself a machine frame. And if I remember correctly, I also need two flint for the pulverizer. Oh, and a gold ingot. Gold ingot. There we go. There we go. Beautiful. So now we got a pulverizer. And we'll just put that right here. This will start powering up. And now I have the capability to ore double, which is great, because that'll let me make my my ores go a lot longer than they would right now. Because right now I'm running a little bit low on some of these. Next, I want to make a pair of redstone furnaces. But let me get this going. I also made a total derp and forgot to replant my wheat field after I got the seeds to 10, 10, 10. So I need to wait on that stuff to grow a little bit as well. So I'm going to start getting some of the resources together for the next part of this little project, and then I'll be right back. All right, guys, I am back, and we are well on our way to having everything we need. So while I'm waiting on that, I do want to go ahead and make some of these leadstone flux ducts right here. These will basically just allow me to transfer power. It's not necessarily going to be pretty, but it will get the job done. So let's get that out, and we're just going to go like this. I'll put the pulverizer on top, and I'm just going to get rid of all that stuff. Okay, now we're going to have a redstone furnace here and a redstone furnace here as soon as I've got the resources for it, and I think I might just have the resources for it now. So let's make a couple of tin gears. Let's also make a few copper gears, and let's make two machine frames. There we go. And then these are making me more copper gears right now as well. So we'll do a little bit of that too. Okay, cool. So for the redstone furnace, I'm going to need some brick, which I have. I'm going to need the basic machine frames, which I have, and I'm going to need a couple of those. And now I should be able to make two redstone furnaces, which will start heating up in just a moment here. And that's what we want. That's good. Next, I want to make an awesome augment for those. This little thing right here, the trivection chamber. Basically, what that's going to allow it to do is that it will only cook food, but when it cooks that food, it's going to give you twice as many. So if you cook two bread, for example, it will give you four toast. And that is going to come in handy because we're going to have a nice little assembly line type thing going here. We'll just take out the redstone control because I really don't need that. And there we go. That will now give us double the amount of whatever we put in. So let's say the pulverizer, outputs to the bottom. This furnace receives from the top and outputs to the bottom, and this furnace receives from the top and we'll say outputs to this side, and then I'll just put a chest right here. Okay, so now I've got 16 flour, which you get by pulverizing wheat, and if we put that in here, it should turn into toast and then turn into, or it should turn into bread first, and then the bread should double and turn into toast. So basically 16 flour is going to give us a whole stack of toast, and we can then use that toast in our generators to power everything we need. Now, this is not an ideal setup as far as looks. I want to eventually kind of hollow out a basement down here and give us a much better looking place. I also really don't want to stay in this house forever because it's really ugly and it was just a random block. But I think you guys kind of get the idea here as far as what I'm going for. And these were harvested right before I started building all this stuff, and as you can see, they're already almost grown. So this little assembly line is going to do all sorts of wonderful things for us. We just drop our wheat into the pulverizer. The pulverizer sends it into the redstone furnace. The redstone furnace sends it into the next one, and then into the chest. And we have toast for days. But guys, I am definitely out of time for this episode. So if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, subscribe, and leave me a comment. I do appreciate it, and it really helps out my channel. You can also find me on Facebook, Twitter, and Twitch. There are links in the video description below, so check that out as well. Otherwise, guys, thanks for watching, and I'll definitely see you next time.